Today, we are learning how to use the tone curve in Zoner Photo Studio X. Howdy everyone, in this video, we're gonna go take a look at how to use the tone curve to play around with our exposure adjustments. So the tone curve is found in the develop module right here, just below color. And the first thing to notice is the diagonal line in this box, which is the be-all and end-all of this tool. This diagonal line can be thought of as an exposure scale for the photograph, with the darkest exposures on the left and the brightest on the right. Above the curve, we can see several colored dots, including the channels like RGB, Luma, red, green, as well as blue. And RGB affects the overall brightness and contrast of a photo, and this is because adjusting contrast in this channel can also affect the color. Luma does virtually the same thing as RGB, except that it primarily affects exposure instead of color. And each color channel adds or subtracts the color we choose to different areas of exposure. And so we're going to discuss how you can use the tone curve to change and manipulate your exposure. If you want to learn how to use the tone curve to make your color corrections, check out this video, wherever that may be, and it'll show you how to do that. But back to editing. I choose the Luma channel since we want to adjust the photo's exposure without significantly affecting the colors. And we've already established that the horizontal axis tells us which area of exposure that we're in. But what does the vertical axis of the tone curve actually tell us? It lets Zoner Photo Studio know how we want to change the exposure in particular areas. The higher the point is on the vertical axis, the brighter it's going to be. And vice versa, the lower the point is, the darker it's going to be. Let's go take a look. If I take this bottom point and drag it up, I can see that the dark areas in the photo get brighter. And if we go back, then they get dark again. But what if we only want to adjust the midtones? I click here, add a point to the curve, and I can move it how I please. If I want to remove a point from the tone curve, we just right click it. And you can have as many points as you like and play around with their settings until you find the exposure that you are happy with. Now that I have more points on the curve, I can see how the curve bends nicely and adjusts to create a smooth transition between the adjustments. Now this is useful, but it's also a double-edged sword in the sense that that smooth transition can show up where we don't want it to. Now, if you want to adjust the shape of the curve, you can click the gear icon here and change the shape of the curve. By default, Cubic Spline tries to create a curve and transition that is as smooth as possible. Now, if we switch to Catmull ROM Spline, the curve will still have smooth transitions, but it's not going to be as noticeable. And most importantly, it will try to make the line between the points as straight as possible and only the curves where the points are. Now with the Catmull ROM Spline, I can isolate a certain part of the exposure and adjust it how I want without affecting the rest of the curve, unlike with the Cubic Spline. Now if we choose Linear, the curve stops curving altogether and creates straight lines without any smooth transitions. And we can change this in this setting whenever we want without affecting the position of each point. And in other words, we don't have to worry about messing anything up by changing and playing around with this mode. Now that you know how to use the tone curve, there's nothing keeping you from using it to the utmost maximum. I hope you guys like this video. Let us know what you think below, or give us some tips on what is missing from your arsenal of tools, and we'll be happy to make it. Subscribe, give us a thumbs up, have a good day. See you later.